Hello everyone. This is my Simple Universal Modem. It's everything a computer or microcontroller needs to convert data to audio and back. It's completely open source, and it's a finalist project in the 2022 Hackaday Prize from the Hack It Back Challenge Round. It's a cheap way of turning any audio recorder into data storage for your retrocomputer or electronics project. It's a way to squeeze a bit more useful life out of an MP3 player or old phone or a tape deck from 1972 like I did. By default, it's configured for frequency shift keying the frequencies used in the Kansas City standard. This means that to save data to audio, the computer has to do some of the heavy lifting, but in return, we have a very cheap modem. Most computers and microcontrollers have an easy way of outputting an audible square wave of a certain frequency. But square waves contain all the harmonics as well, and that introduces problems when recovering the data from audio. For this reason, the project has an active RC filter to smooth the harsh square wave into an almost clean sine wave, modulating the data into a format that's more suitable for an audio medium. Since the data saved as audio is now analog audio instead of digital, we could use an ADC, an analog to digital converter, to analyze the audio and convert the frequencies back to data, but that would be a tough solution for older equipment. We could also make a complicated circuit to recover the data and convert it to serial, which was usually what a modem did up until the end of the last century. But since we can make the reasonable assumption that our computer or microcontroller supports interrupts and the signal is reasonably clean, there's an easier and cheaper way. By feeding the audio into a comparator, we can easily detect the serial crossing point of the sine waves, which turns our analog audio back into a digital signal we can feed into the input pin of our computer or microcontroller, essentially demodulating the audio. From there, it's a relatively simple task for the computer to measure the time since the last falling edge to decode the data. Doing it this way means we save a lot of hardware, but still have a universally viable solution that works no matter if the computer is an ESP, an Arduino Uno, an ATtiny85, or even a 6502 from 1975. And no matter if the audio device is a computer, an old phone, or an ancient tape deck. To avoid cutting wires or buying adapters, the four poles of the 3.5mm connector are jumper reconfigurable for the most common in pinouts, and the modulation output and input pins are also broken out if you want to skip the mini jack connector completely. What you see here is an example of how I used the Simple Universal Modem to save a BASIC program from my 6502 single board computer and load it back into BASIC. I previously released a longer video where I go into a bit more detail about how saving data to consumer tape became a thing in the 1970s and the hurdles I had to go through to restore my reel-to-reel tape deck from 1972 and save data. All the hardware files for the project are available on GitHub, and you'll find much more information on the hackaday.io project page. Links are in the description. Thanks for watching, and good luck to all finalists of the 2022 Hackaday Prize.